with me, Loy. This path leads to the cut. The Banuk have nothing to offer besides useless mysticism. The Eclipse won't stand idle while you waste time playing in the snow. Return to your task.
Surprised you're still checking up on me. I thought you had moved on.
Well, forgive me for still being concerned with the fate of the world.
I was thinking. Rost used to tell me stories about the Banuk and their shamans, and how they thread blue cables through their skin. Kind of like someone else we know, huh? So maybe the real reason you want me to stay clear of the Banuk is to stay clear of your past.
It's not the past that concerns me, Loy. It's the future. Or possible lack thereof. Which is why you should stop prattling and get back to what matters. But as usual, you'll do as you wish.
Touchy. Welcome, I guess.
Ha! You sure you'll be warm enough up here, Nora?
I've worked up a sweat from the climb.
You made it to the cut, Outlander.
Not that you'll stay long.
Smoke rising from the mountain. From the village, too. What's it for?
Shaman has abandoned us. Our chieftain has led our best to their deaths. Where should we find help?
Trust Araya, they say. She'll return to us, they say. And yet here we are.
Our hunters
must be something big
well.
Going on.
Their songs will be remembered.
Smoke.
We suffered a great loss, but we must trust our attack.
Get ready for a rare sight, Nora.
Burgrind, purveyor of necessities. Most of the time, the Banuk burn their dead. But not today.
Because the bodies couldn't be recovered.
Aye. A nasty business. All their best warriors. Lost. So they're getting a different kind of send-off.
Grasp your grief, my hunters, and kill it! For our kin sees the fate all Banuk long for. Falling with their spears striking steel. Their struggle is over now. You have witnessed their spirits rise up into the blue sky and beyond to the blue light. But our struggle is only beginning. Soon, we will again take up the hunt against the daemon that frenzies the machines against us. And so I ask you, can you summon the courage of our fallen kin? Will you fight and die as well as they did?
My courage! My spear!
Blood is in your teeth, Orotok!
We are Banuk. Our enemies are prey.
The daemon that frenzies the machines.
Machines that wiped out their best. And what do they want to do? Go back up there. Fools. A little advice, for free.
Aloy.
Aloy. I've been up here for two long winters, and I still can't make sense of the Banuk. Take this ruckus. It started with one of their shamans, Aurea, spouting on about spirits and daemons up on Thunder's Drum. So they march their Werric up there, and half of them get slaughtered by machines. When Aurea vanished, I thought the crazy might have gone with her. But no. Here's Big Orotok, gearing them up to do it all over again.
What is it about the Banuk you can't make sense of?
Well, everything's a test to them. A hardship to endure. A challenge to survive.
Seems like they don't have much of a choice in a place like this.
Yeah. A land cold enough to crack teeth. Filled. Animals. You think they'd accept a little reasonably priced aid? Well, believe me, I've tried to convince them, but a Banuk with nothing left to prove might just lie down and die.
Have you ever heard of a man named Silence? Tall, deadly serious, cables in his skin, like a shaman?
I've heard that name once or twice, but always whispered, like some boogeyman the Banuk want to forget. I'm not sure what went down, but I got the impression he messed with the Conclave. Or they messed with him.
Conclave.
All the most important shamans gather in Benur from time to time to keep up with the latest mumbo-jumbo. No idea how they all fit into one tent without those crazy headdresses getting locked up on each other. Araya's been to that shindig, but when I asked her what it's like, she just gave me a dirty look. So if you want to know more, you'll have to find her and make her like you, I guess. Good luck.
I want to know more about this daemon.
Mm-mm. It's crazy talk, Aloy.
Or there's something to it. Something connected to how the machines behave.
Then you need to find Araya. She was last seen headed for the mountains they call the Ice Rests. I've heard only the shamans know the trail beyond those frozen peaks. But I do know where you could find her apprentice, Naltuk. He went north of the river, chasing rumors.
Rumors?
Not the good kind. Sudden attacks in the snow. Strange new structures. Some say a new machine, like no one's seen before.
Well, now I'm definitely interested. Thanks for the talk, Bergrund.
Don't mention it.
I wonder if Aratok could tell me more about Araya or Thunder's Drum. Might be worth a shot.
Makes for a nice story.
Okay, if I want to learn more about how this daemon affects the machines, I've got to find Araya. To do that, I need to talk to her apprentice, who followed the river north. Bergrund said Araya's apprentice went north of the river. Hopefully not too far. A Talnik? What did it take to knock one of those off? Or he's the race. Still a long time ago. The scavengers have just gotten started. Oh, boy. That's the last of the scavengers. Should scan the tall neck. See how deep the damage goes. I could use my focus to look around. It looks like the scavengers ripped out three major parts. If I could bring them back, maybe I could even reactivate it. But it wasn't inside its head. Very cold. I get it. Seems intact. Till next are real tough.
Thank you.
This might even the odds. This tonic, but it's still in one piece. I hope it works. Well, it's in better shape than it was.
Never easy.
machine that big down. I should be able to jump onto the tall neck from here. Okay, time to climb up to its head. That must be Naltuk, looking out of that. Naltuk?
Who are you? How did you find me?
Burgrund told me you'd be out here.
He's persistent. I've told that Osteram 1,000 times. I don't need to buy anything.
And I'm not selling. I just need to find Araya.
Well, you won't. She's gone where only shamans can tread. She seeks guidance from the voice in the blue light. That is her task. And the task she gave me is to observe the daemon's work. To stop it spreading, if I can. What can I do about these towers? In only a few weeks, they've sprouted throughout the cut. The daemon's energy pulses from them. Rallies the machines, even repairs them.
Alright, you want to stop the spread of the daemon's work? I know how to get started. With my bow and spear.
Outlander, wait. Won't you tell me your name?
Aloy.
Good. If you fall to the daemon's machines, at least I can properly recount your efforts to Araya.
Thanks for the vote of confidence. But I won't fall. And when I'm done, you're gonna tell me where she is. Easy. I can kill the machines. I might be able to destroy them. Destroyed. I can't even make a dent in that thing.
We should speak.
Now we know how to deal with the machines and the towers. The daemon's next.
Perhaps Araya should meet you after all. What she truly seeks is hope. After what I just saw, you could show her that. She's in retreat beyond those mountains. the ice rasps. You'll have to walk the shaman's path to get there. You'll know you've reached the end when you come to a shrine. A great machine covered in blue gleam. Shamans who complete the path take a piece of it as reward. If you make it that far. You should too. You'll have earned it.
How do I cross this shaman's path?
Go to the ice rasps. Then follow the markers through the ice caves and the waterfalls and make the climb to the shrine. But be careful. The path is meant to be an ordeal, the final trial of a young shaman's training.
And I'll find Araya at the end of it?
No. She goes further up, somewhere inside the mountain. If you see her, would you tell her, I have faith she will hear the voice again.
All right, I guess I'm off to the ice rasps to find this shaman's path. Ready. These mountains must be there. The shaman's path to be far off cliff. pretty far up. The shaman's path must be... This must be one of the markers Naltuk told me about. Looks like each marker points to another, giving directions. Guess we're heading deeper into the cold, creepy ice cave. What's this chime for? To help guide the way with sound? If there's more, maybe my focus can find them. Not this way. This isn't the way out. Some gear, though. At least their stuff. Took a wrong turn. Yep, focus can pick up the chimes. Should help me find my way. Another marker. Good. That way, then. Back after I grab this loot. Done with the cave. So what's next on this path? Thank you. Now how do I cross this one? Down it is. Here's the way up. I need to pull the rope to move this thing into position. Okay, the bridge is filling up. Wasn't exaggerating. There's definitely something new out here. And I don't think it's friendly. I can't feel much of anything in this. try reaching that tower to override it. Okay, then. Let's see if this thing can work for me. Here we go again. I should be able to get it clear. This must be the shrine Neltuk was talking about. Guess I should take some blue gleam. Neltuk said Rhea went past the shrine, up into the mountain. I'd better take those stairs. An ancient door. Maybe Rhea's inside.
March 10th, 2046. I just spent 16 hours in here trying to install upgrades to improve efficiency for the central processing unit. Project Firebreak is going to need the brain power.
Locked. Maybe my focus can help. Looks like the door's wired. Something over here.
Director of Security Blevins is riding us like a petty tyrant.
Those nodes on the floor must be connected to the door. Something. What am I supposed to do with these lights? All right. Let's see if the door's open. Fresh air ahead. Out again. Maybe I can get back inside through that structure over there. Looks like I need to get to those stairs. Not much higher to climb. Maria must be close. She has to be in here somewhere.
ask again, as I've asked 1,000 times. Speak to me. What more would you have me do? Is there no prayer that will reach you? No mark that will break your bonds? Ah! I can't help you if you won't speak! A whisper is all I ask. To guide me. Who? No. How? How did you get here? The way was sealed by the spirit herself.
I used one of these. I could show you.
Yes, show me. Please.
Goal's the same. Get the light back to the source.
Channel recovered. Exploit successful. Restraints evaded. Is someone there? Aurea? Aurea, I need you.
Return to schedule task.
brought the spirit's voice back. You heard it. A voice of the spirit calling to me from the heights of Thunder's Drum. She was able to throw off the bonds of the Daemon for a moment. Because of what you did. Who are you? And what do you want?
I'm Aloy. Now Took sent me. He thought that you could use my help.
He was not mistaken. You've been a revelation. Now I know for certain that the spirit endures. Perhaps together we can find a way to set her free.
Let's not get ahead of ourselves. I came all this way for answers, and so far, I haven't heard any.
It seems to me that you are the answer. But of course, I'll tell you all I can.
The Daemon. What do you know about it?
I spoke with the spirit many times. First here, then inside Thunder's Drum. The last time. She told me she was under attack by something that could not be seen by mortal eyes. Something evil. She named it the Daemon, and said it needed her power to do what it willed. And she begged me for help, to find a way to destroy her, if necessary, to keep it from using her. That was 5 years ago. I didn't hear her voice again until today.
Let's see if I've got this straight. We heard two voices. One you call the spirit, captured somehow by the one you call a daemon. Whatever this daemon is, it's related to the machines and why they've become more dangerous. I want to know how. Both the spirit and the daemon are on a mountain, Thunder's Drum. So why don't we go there and figure out what it all means?
We can't. Thunder's Drum is dangerous, more than you can imagine. The daemon has secured it. Besides, Aratak won't let us go. As chieftain, he controls the pass to the mountain, and he can't be reasoned with.
Sounds like you need a new chieftain.
Huh. There's an idea that's certain to win us friends. You said you were a hunter. And I'll wager you're not an ordinary one. It's not impossible. Even for an outlander. An Aratak couldn't refuse the challenge if you were known among the Werak.
Wait, me? Challenge Aratak? I don't want to be chieftain of anything, much less a bunch of Banuk that don't want me.
But you want to go to Thunder's Drum, don't you? You heard the spirit. She is suffering, tormented by the daemon. She longs to be free. And perhaps, when released from her bonds, she can give you the answers you seek.
I can't believe I'm agreeing to this. Fine. What do I have to do?
Get the Werak's attention to show the worth of your claim. Win at the hunting grounds. Kill bandits that prey on the cut. Or speak to my friend, Sekuli. You help her, you'll definitely get noticed. Do all you can. When the time comes for you to throw your spear at Aratak's feet, I will be there to back your claim. Until then, I'll be here to answer any questions you have about the challenge. Oh, and one more thing. In the box over there is a weapon, like my own. Take it. You may find it useful.